What I hope to do in this video is leverage some of our experience and knowledge from the quadratic world to factor and rewrite and re-express expressions that are higher degree polynomials. So what am I talking about? So let's say that I have the expression a to the sixth power plus 2a to the third power b squared plus b to the fourth. And I want to factor this. I want to write this as the product of two expressions. How do I do that? And at first, it might seem a little intimidating. I have a to the sixth power. This is a sixth degree term. You have a b to the fourth power. How do I handle it? But a clue, you might say, well, you know, this is kind of looking like when I took a square of a expression with two variables. So let's just take a little bit of a detour here. If I took x plus y squared, what is this going to be equal to? Well, this is x plus y times x plus y, which is, of course, going to be equal to x times x is x squared. Then you have x times y is xy, but then you have y times x as well, so you have two xy's. And this is all a review. If this isn't review, I encourage you to watch the videos on multiplying expressions. And then, or multiplying binomials, I guess you could say. And then you finally have y times y. So you'd have plus y squared. So when you write it like this, you see, well, look, it looks like there might be a parallel. This a to the sixth term looks like it might parallel to this x squared term. And this b to the fourth might looks like it might parallel to this. Because notice, if I have something squared here, and then I have that something in this middle term, and I have something squared here, and I have that something in that middle term, and then I have a 2, well, then that means that this thing is a perfect square. It's x plus y squared. And we do have that. Notice, a to the sixth, that's the same thing as a to the third squared. And then we have an a to the third right here, sitting in this middle term. So let me write that. We have that a to the third there. And of course, we have this plus 2 there. And then b to the fourth, well, that's the same thing as b squared squared. And of course, we also have a b squared in this middle term. So when you write it this way, it has the exact same pattern as we had right over here. This thing is nothing but, let me write it this way, as a to the third, let me do it in those colors, as a to the third, plus b squared, and then that whole quantity squared. And you can see, look, if we were to multiply it out, and actually, let me just do it. I'll do it all in white so it makes sense to you. Or so actually, it might make a little less sense because I'm not going to take, actually, let me switch colors. So it's going to be a to the third plus, let me do it. So you have a to the third plus b squared, times a to the third plus b squared. Well, a to the third times a to the third is a to the sixth. A to the third plus b squared, that's going to be a to the third b squared. And then you're going to have b squared times a to the third. Well, that's just another a to the third b squared. So actually, let's just write this as 2 a to the third b squared. And then finally, b squared times b squared is going to be b to the fourth power. So once again, if you see something like this, you're like, okay, this seems daunting, but it seems close to a pattern that I've seen when I've been dealing with quadratics. This looks close to a perfect square quadratic. And if you actually write this out, it's actually a pretty big hint. You see, well, look, if x is a to the third and y is b squared, then these are the exact same thing. So this is a factored out version of it. Let's do another one of these. So let's say, let me draw a little dotted line here. Let's say that we have an eighth degree polynomial. We have x to the eighth minus 12x to the fourth minus 2. And we want to complete the square here. And you're probably used to completing the square with second degree polynomials or quadratics. And now all of a sudden you have an eighth degree. But there's no reason why you can't do that here. Because we could say this is going to be the same thing as x to the eighth minus 12x to the fourth power. Whoops. My primitive brain wrote x squared there. X to the 8th minus 12 x to the 4th. And let me create some space to add and subtract something, and then let me put the minus 2 out here. And we just have to realize that, look, for it to be a perfect square, that this is x to the 4th squared right over here. We have an x to the 4th here. And so just like we would complete the square if we were doing it with a second degree polynomial or quadratic, we would take half the coefficient here, which is 6, and then we would want to add that. So we would want to add, well, we wouldn't add half that coefficient. We would add the square of half that coefficient. This is just how you complete the square. If this was an x squared and this was just an x. And the key here is just realize that x to the 8th is x to the 4th squared. When you did it with quadratics, you just had an x here and you just had the x squared. Now you have an x to the 4th here and you have x to the 4th squared, which is x to the 8th. But you take half of this coefficient, which was 6, and you could view it as negative 6 since you have this out here, but then you square it and you get 36. But you can't just add 36 willy-nilly to an expression. That changes its value. In order to not change its value, you also need to subtract 36. But the whole point of doing it is this part of it now is a perfect square. It's a perfect square 8th degree polynomial. So this is going to be the same thing as x to the fourth minus, let me write it this way, x to the 4th minus 6 squared. Maybe I should have written this in blue. The colors are the hard part. X to the 4th minus 6. And then the whole thing squared, and then of course I have to worry about these two characters out here. Minus, if I subtract 36 and then subtract 2, well that's the same thing as subtracting 38. So just like that, this is just like completing the square with a second degree polynomial, but I just did it with an 8th degree polynomial. Let's do one more, just to really exercise this muscle. This in some ways isn't a new skill. This is just looking at an old skill and applying it to slightly hairier, slightly more complex things, or maybe realizing that they aren't that more complex. So let's say that we had 25 x to the 6th minus 16y squared. So let's do this at the top. What are other ways we can write this? Can we factor things? What are other ways we could write it? Well, one way that we could write it, we could say that, look, 25 is 5 squared, and x to the 6th is x to the 3rd squared. So we could rewrite this right over here as 5 squared times x to the 3rd squared, and then we have minus 16 is 4 squared. Let me do this in this color. 16 is 4 squared y squared. So we could write it like this if we like, but we could also write it. We have 5 to the second power, and we have x to the 3rd to the second power. Well, we could use our exponent property to say, well, this is going to be the same thing as 5x to the 3rd to the second power. If I have a product of two things and I raise it to the power, this is the same thing as taking the product of each of them raised to the power. Or if I take the product and then raise it to the power, that's the same thing as raising them each to the power first and then taking the product. It's one of our exponent properties. And we could do the same thing. We could do the same thing for the second term. 4 squared times y squared is the same thing as 4y squared. And when you write it like this, and this is another legitimate way to rewrite this higher degree expression, you now see that this is a difference of squares. And if it's a difference of squares, we can rewrite it as, we can write it, let me do it like this. We can rewrite it as 5x to the third plus 4y times 5x to the third minus 4y. Once again, this comes straight out of when you first learned a squared minus b squared is equal to a plus b times a minus b. In this case, a is 5x to the third power, and b is 4y. And you see that right over here. So once again, whole point here is just apply some of our quadratic toolkit, but applying it to higher degree polynomials and seeing that it's really, on some levels, the same thing.